When I first started as a curator, I didn't know what I was getting into for sure. And I really saw a few people around, Archaeo of Ontario or any number of the so-called public institutions that we see today. There were no Indigenous curators at all. So I was not the first one, but the only one. And so to think about others, to talk with others, to exchange ideas was really shouting into a hollow sphere with no feedback loop. We can visualize the world from different perspectives, and there's different ways of presenting works into these exhibition spaces. And I think the biggest part of my work has been to introduce more Indigenous art into the collection. And instead of presenting it in an art historical way, by particular movements through time, what we did was to thematize exhibitions. And by doing that, it allowed us to juxtapose various artists, both women, Indigenous, and male Canadian artists together, and present them in a way that had never been done before. What we wanted to say was that there are different ways of seeing the same thing. So by bringing these new ways of seeing an Indigenous examples of seeing a landscape, was really expanding our view of what Canadian art could be. Historically, institutions have taken that authority away from Indigenous peoples, but now investing it back in Indigenous curators and Indigenous folks, this question of authority. And I think that's a very, very powerful example of the responsibility of young curators. Seeing this growth of young people coming up today has been, I'm proud of that. That knowledge base is there for them to take hold of and to do something themselves. For the first many years of my life, I didn't quite have that.